योपाकरोत् तं प्रवरं मुनीनां पतञ्जलि प्राञ्जलिरानतोऽस्मि।
सर प्लीज स्टार्ट। सर हेलो
सर, हमारे बीच से डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए हैं, अभी फिर जुड़ गए हैं। जी जी
हाँ, आ गए आ गए।
ये आ गए जी। सर आप स्टार्ट कीजिए। हेलो,
फिर से डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए सर। आप कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाएं, आशा कि मैं आपका स्वागत करते हुए आप भी आमंत्रित कर रहे
हैं।
हाँ
मामा, ये सर। ओं मूकं करोति वाचालं पुंगुं लंघयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंद माधवम्। ओं सदाशिव समारंभम् शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्त्याम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। We are pleased to inform you that Global Sanskrit Forum West Bengal branch is going to organize the third special lecture on Yogas Chittavritti Nirodha. We are kind enough to Professor Indulata Das, Director of Academy of Yoga and Oriental Studies, Bhubaneswar, because she is giving the series of lectures. We are very much thankful to her, Madam. Pranam, Madam. Now, today she will deliver the lecture, the second lecture on Yogas Chittavritti Nirodha. We are very much thankful to Professor Das for her kind association with us. Now I request Professor Niranjan Jena, head of the Department of Pali, Prakrit, Pali and Prakrit, Prakrit and Sanskrit, Divya Bharati University, to deliver few words.
Namaskar. We welcome all to this online special lecture of Professor Indulata Das. This is the third lecture series of Professor Indulata Das. The first lecture was on Swadhyaya, and the second lecture was on Yoga Chittavritti Nirodha, the part one. And today, that same Yoga Chittavritti Nirodha will be continued, the second part. And we are very much enlightened by Madam's lecture. Really, when we heard her lecture, very unique on the basis of the original text and Shastras, yogic text, and the real sense or real understanding about the concept from her lecture, we are getting a clear idea. So today also it is our privilege to listen her lecture, and I see here so many scholars from all over India, from Chennai. Just I saw Dr. Ganesh S. Ganesh is there, and so many scholars and the research scholars also are there. And this is the our privilege through the Global Sanskrit Forum. Dr. Rajesh Kumar Mishra ji is very kind enough to arrange this type of academic activities for us, and our coordinator Dr. Chinmoy Mandal from Jadavpur University is also with us. Now let us start and listen Professor Madam's lecture. And Madam, on behalf of the Global Sanskrit Forum, we heartily welcome you for the third lecture. Please, Madam, now let us start the program.
Thank you. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasya Pihitam Mukham Tattvam Kusana Pabrano Satya Dharma Drushtaye. I thank the organizers of Global Sanskrit Forum who have given me this opportunity to deliver a few lectures in front of the august audience. Initially, as you know, the lecture was on Swadhyaya. The second was on Chitta, Chitta Bhumi, and Chitta Vrittis. Today, I will discuss on the derivation and definition of yoga. With your permission, I want to share the screen with the write-up.
You can, ma'am.
Thank you. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yoga derivation and definition, is it visible?
Oh, yoga derivation.
Not visible, ma'am.
Not visible?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Then whether it is visible or not, I want to know.
Madam, screen.
Madam, it is not visible.
Na screen le dekha dao ni?
Nahi.
Nahi, madam. Aao tere try karo.
Achha, achha. Aao tere
try karo. On share screen, ma'am. Yes.
Now, okay, madam, it is okay.
Now, is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, madam. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. So this is yoga derivation and definition. I'm Indulata Das. You have already introduced me. The derivation of the word yoga. What is the how the word yoga has been derived from what? Which dhatu it comes? From what is the dhatu? What is the root from which it is derived? In the beginning, I must tell you that there is a lot of confusion about the dhatu from which it is derived. Many people nowadays, they do not know about the original dhatu. They go on saying that it is juj dhatu and juj means union. No, that is not the case. The dhatu is juj and juj samadho, natu jujir joge. The word yoga, which we are discussing today, the word yoga is derived from juj samadho, natu jujir joge. I will discuss gradually. So it is juj samadho, samadhi. The meaning is samadhi, not union. So Patanjali defines yoga as yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. What is yoga? Yoga is nothing but chitta vritti nirodha. No union, nothing else. So this is the definition of chitta. And yoga, and that yoga is samadhi, because it is derived from the root samadho. Therefore, that yoga is samadhi. And Vyasadeva, in his Bhashya, Vyasa Bhashya of Yoga Sutra, which is written on Yoga Sutra, he clearly mentions that yoga is samadhi, not union, it is samadhi. And in Yoga Karika also, we find that sa yoga ba samadhi syat, that yoga is samadhi. In Gita, the word samadhista and yogastha are frequently used. In Bhagavad Gita, all of you must have read, in Bhagavad Gita, the word samadhistha and yogastha are frequently used. For example, Sita Prajna Shaka Bhasa Samadhisthasya Kesava. Here, samadhistha is the word. And again, yogastha Kuru Karmani. Here, the word is yogastha. So, yoga is the state of samadhi. Samahita avastha. Then, other synonyms used for samadhi. What are the other synonyms? There are many other words which are synonyms of samadhi. And in Hatha Yoga Pradipika, we find a number of words. The sloka is like this. Raja Yoga Samadhischa Unmanicha Manonmani Amaratvam Layas Tattvam Sunya Sunyam Param Pada Amanaskam Tatha Dvaitam Niralambam Niranjana Jivan Muktischa Sahaja Turja Chet Ekavachakaha. These words are Ekavachaka. These are synonymous words. And what are the words? I have already told this sloka. Now, in English, the words are like this. Raja Yoga, Samadhi, Unmani, Manonmani, Amaratva, Laya, Tattva, Sunya Sunya, Parava, Pada, Amanaska, Advaita, Niralamba, Niranjana, Jivan Mukti, Sahajavastha, Turiyavastha, etc. All these are synonyms of samadhi or yoga. Now, it is Lee. And what is samadhi? Samadhi is to collect together the vrittis of the mind which are distracted here and there. And what are the vrittis? Last time I have explained, vrittis are nothing but the activities of the mind. In common language, we call them thoughts of the mind. The thoughts which are entering our mind every moment and going out of our mind every moment, these are called vrittis in technical terms. In yogic vocabulary, we call it vrittis. So it is a state which is completely, in which the mind is completely conquered. Conquering the mind means conquering the vrittis of the chitta. In this state of samadhi, there are two states of samadhi. Again, number one, either there is no vritti at all. It is a state, conquered state. But in that conquered state also, there are two states. And number one, there is no vritti at all. There is no activity of the mind. There is no thought of the mind. The yogi will not entertain any vritti in his mind. He will simply back at the mind. The mind is completely empty. The yogi, and how it is compared in Bhagavad Gita, it is compared like this. Yatha dipo nivatasto nengate sopamasuta yogi no jata chittasya yunyato jogamatmanaha. The state of mind is unquivering like the flame of a lamp kept in a place without air. Not without air, without movement of air. The flame does not move, does not quiver at all. So the mind is completely stable and there is no movement of the mind, there is no movement of any thought in the mind, there is no vritti in the mind. It is vrittiless state. The yogi has completely emptied the mind. Na kinchid api chintayet. Na kinchid api chintayet. In Bhagavad Gita, it is said that in this state, yogi will not think of anything, he will not entertain any vritti. So, and this is called asamprajnata samadhi. This is the highest state, where there is no vritti and the yogi can keep the mind vrittiless. This is the highest state, and in yogic parlance it is called asamprajnata samadhi. Then there is another state which is a lower state, that is one vritti. There will be vritti in the mind and there will be only one vritti, and that will be chosen by the yogi, entertained by the choice of the yogi. The yogi will choose which vritti I will entertain and which vritti I do not want to entertain. So the yogi selects the vritti to be entertained. Which vritti will enter to his mind, the yogi will decide. For example, Mirabai entered one vritti or one kind of vrittis only. The vrittis related to Lord Krishna only, his Ishta Devata, her Ishta Devata, and she was capable of entertaining those vrittis at all the time, and she did not want to entertain other vrittis. This is called Sampragya, the Samadhi. Yogi is the master. In both the cases, yogi is the master of his mind. Either he can entertain any vritti, or he will not entertain any vritti. He will vacate the mind. This is the state of samadhi. This is the state of yoga. This is called yoga. Now, mind is made default. Here, mind will become functionless. Another name of this samadhi, as I have already told the synonyms, unmani. That means yatra gatva tu manaso manastam naiva vidyate unmani sa samakhyata sarva tantresu gopita. This is in sat chakra nirupana. That is unmani avastha or the samadhi avastha or yoga avastha. In this state, the mind loses its existence, because mind means the activity of the mind. When there is no activity of the mind, there is no mind at all. Mind is not capable of doing any activity on its own. Mind cannot function at all. Mind is totally under the control of the yogi. This is also called mano-nasa. The yogi kills the mind. Mind is killed. Mind, nasa, mano-nasa. Mano-nasa and mano-laya, these are technical words of yoga, yogic parlance. And these two words are also, they also mean the state of samadhi. Now, yogi is established in himself. In this state, yogi, what happens to the yogi? Yogi goes back to his original state. We are not in our original state. We are not living in our original state. Only when we reach the state of samadhi, then only we'll go back to the to our own original state. It is a state where the mind is completely withdrawn. Yogi is in himself. In Bhagavad Gita, we find the description of this state. Yatra paramate chittam niruddham yoga sevaya yatra chaiva atmanam yatra chaiva atmanam pashyan atmani tushyati. He sees himself by himself and he is satisfied. He sees himself by himself only. Now he himself is there and nothing else is there. So he has gone back to his own original state. And in Yoga Sutra also, we find the sutra tada drashtuhu so rupe avasthanam. Tada drashtuhu so rupe avasthanam. The purusha is established in his own original state. And what happens to the yogi in other states? What happens to the human being in other state? Vritti sarupya mitaratra. This sutra is not written here in Yoga Sutra. It is written vritti sarupya mitaratra in other states. Except samadhi state, except the state of yoga, the yogi identifies himself with the vrittis of the mind. So it is the only state when there is no vritti, or he has complete control over the vritti, that is the state of yoga, or that is the state of samadhi. Now, and why should he go there? Now, because there is no sorrow in this state. It is a state of mind where the yogi is separated from all kinds of sorrows. What is our goal of life? Our goal of life is to become happy, to be happy, to get rid of all the sorrows, all the three kinds of sorrows, adhyatmika, adhibhautika, and adhidaivika sorrows. All these sorrows, we are always disturbed. We are always inflicted by these sorrows. And we want to be happy. We want to get rid of all these sorrows. And yogi gets rid of all the sorrows and he experiences unending happiness in the state of yoga, in the state of samadhi. Tang vidya dukha sanyoga biyogam yoga sangitam. That is yoga sangita. Yoga sangita means that is the word called yoga, or the sangha called yoga, that is dukkha sanyoga vyogam. It is the state of yoga where he is separated or disunited from all kinds of sorrows. Here there is no sorrow at all. Otherwise, why should one go to that state? Because he is happy. There is unending happiness. And in Bhagavad Gita also we find the description. Jasmin sthito na dukhe na guruna api vicharyate. It is a state where the yogi is nowhere disturbed even by the severest of sorrow. It is a state of happiness only. There is no sorrow. No sorrow can disturb the yogi. So he goes back to his original state where there is no sorrow at all and enjoys complete and permanent happiness. He experiences the aikantika and atyantika happiness. Aikantika, complete and permanent happiness. Complete happiness and also permanent happiness. In Bhagavad Gita, we again find sukham atyantikam jatat buddhi graham atindriyam metti jatrana chaivayam sthitas chalati tattvatah. That means the yogi enjoys the happiness which is beyond the perception of the indriyas. We experience happiness or pleasure through the indriyas, but the happiness experienced by the yogi is not experienced through the indriyas. This happiness is grasped only by the buddhi, and he never moves from the enjoyment of this bliss once he is established in this state of yoga. So it is an unending happiness. It is an eternal happiness, permanent happiness that he enjoys. Now, this is the highest state of mind. This is the highest state of chitta. In the last lecture, I had discussed about the chitta bhumis. There are five chitta bhumis, mudra, kipta, vikhipta, ekagra, and niruddha. And this is the highest state. That is, it is either niruddha or ekagra state. In niruddha is the highest state, and ekagra is also a state where sampragyanta samadhi is possible. So it is the highest state of mind. He goes to the highest state of mind. It is actually, it is the best psychology. It is to go from the lower to the highest state of mind. Now, explanation of the five chitta bhumis. Those who have not attended, we have not attended the last class, I will speak only very shortly. I will describe the five chitta bhumis. Khipta, mudha, and vikhipta states of mind are like this. Sadasthira bhavet khipta mudha mohavasatatha. Khipta visishta vikhipta stalja stalja tikahisa. That means khipta is always restless. Mudha state is full of moha. Vikhipta is a state where the mind is sometimes stable and sometimes it is unstable. And for example, Shakuntala was sitting in the mudha state when sage Durvasa came. And she was cursed. It was not a state of samadhi. It was a mudra state. So these are the three states. Then the ekagra state. Ekasmin nishtaye bhate samsaktam gatra lila. Ekagra chitta bhumisha sampragyana prasurmata. Here sampragyanta samadhi is possible when the mind is capable of attaching itself on any object very easily. And this chitta bhumi is called ekagra state. It leads to sampragyanta samadhi, sampragyanta yoga. Now niruddha state of the mind, that is highest state, sanskara matra sesa ja pratyaya rahita sada, sa niruddha samakhyata yogasya mukhya bhumika. This is the mukhya bhumika. Mukhya bhumika means the main, the highest bhumi. When the mind has the capability to have no vritti at all, it is the niruddha state. There are sanskaras only and no vrittis in niruddha state. Now, let us see definitions of yoga given in some other texts. What are the definitions given in other texts, other books? Bhagavata, let us see Bhagavata. In Bhagavata, we find the same thing. Parohi yoga manasa samadhi, mana samadhi, samadhi of the mind. Samadhi of the mind is the great yoga. Yoga is nothing but the samadhi of the mind. Then we come to Gharanda Sanghita. Gharanda Sanghita is a Hatha yogic text. Samadhi stu para yoga bahu bhagyana labhyate. Samadhi is the great yoga which is obtained due to great fortune. So here also we find that samadhi, yoga is the samadhi. Then we come to Kurma Purana. Mayeka chittata yoga vrittyantara nirodhataha. here the Samprakyanta Samadhi is meant, that the meaning of the sloka is like this: to concentrate on me by removing all other vrittis is yoga. Of course, this is Samprakyanta Yoga. When there is vritti in the mind, that is Samprakyanta Yoga. Then again, in Katha Upanishad, we find Tang Yoga Miti Manyante Sthiram Indriya Dharanam. That means holding the indriya, that is, this indriya is mind. Holding the indriya or mind motionless is yoga, Katha Upanishad. So holding the mind motionless, there will be no motion in the mind, there will be no vritti in the mind. That is called yoga. Now, why this is called indriya sthiram indriya dharanam? Indriya here is mana. Mana is both a Gyanendriya and a Karmendriya. So it is an indriya. And Sankhya Karika, Ubhayatmaka Matra Manaha. Mana is both a Gyanendriya and also a Karmendriya. Again in Katha Upanishad we find about yoga. Yada panchavatishtante gyanani manusasa buddhishchana vichestati tamahu paramangati. That is the paramagati. When the five gyanas mean Gyanendriyas, along with the mind remain motionless, and the buddhi too ceases exerting, it is called the highest state, that is the state of samadhi. Now when these things, mana and all this, they will not exert, they will not function, they will not do anything. Now we come to Sandilya Upanishad. In Sandilya Upanishad also, yoga vritti nirodha hi gyanam samyak anvekshanam. Yoga is the arrest of the vrittis, and knowledge is to observe perfectly. Here also yoga is vritti nirodha. And again we come to Yoga Vasishta. In Yoga Vasishta also we find yoga vritti nirodha hi. Yoga is vritti nirodha. Vritti of the mind, nirodha, yoga nirodha. Vritti nirodha means nirodha of the vrittis. And again we come to Yoga Karika. Sarvasang Vestavarjanang vritti nang yat nirodhana sa yoga va samadhi syad atyanta tapasadana. That means the cessation of all the vrittis, or the vrittis which are undesirable, is called yoga, which is also known as samadhi. It is the final destroyer of all afflictions. So this is the state of samadhi or yoga. Samadhi or yoga, this is the state. These are the descriptions. Now there are some confusions. Some people are confused. They are confused themselves, because they don't go through the books, they don't read shastras, they are confused themselves, and they also confuse others. And they may even yamanaha jathandhaha. They are confused themselves, and they also go on confusing others. So removed, it is our duty, it is our sacred duty to remove the confusions. Now, what is the confusion? There is another root. There is another dhatu called yujir, yoga. Yoga here means addition. Yoga of yoga. That means to add. 2 yoga 2 is 4. That is yoga. By suffixing bhaya, the word yoga is also derived. Here, yoga means addition. 1 plus 1 is 2. This addition, this yoga is addition. This yoga means association, union, or addition. Some people try to use this word to be yoga, and they interpret that union of Jivatma and Paramatma is called yoga. You must have heard everybody saying that, oh yes, yoga means union, and to the union of Jivatma and Paramatma is yoga. Simple. There is no way they can describe it. They can't describe it, but they will give a flying statement that yoga means union, and union of Jivatma and Paramatma is yoga. And who is this Jivatma? Who is Paramatma? Why they are separated? Why they are going to be united? What is the method to be united? Nothing. There is nothing. In Yoga Sutra, you find Yoga Chittavritti Nirodha. Then every step, what are the vrittis, how many vrittis are there, how nirodha is done, what are the methods of nirodha, what are the obstacles of nirodha, how to get rid of the obstacles, then what are the secondary benefits, what are the vibhutis on the way, and then ultimately there is the Kaivalya, or there is the final state of Kaivalya when the Purusha becomes single and he is disunited with everything else, and he reaches the state of yoga or samadhi at the end. He is liberated. Kaivalyam avashishya, there is Kaivalya. So in detail, every step by step, everything is written. But you ask these people, who is a jivatma, who is paramatma, why they are separated, what is the method to be united, and then what will happen, whether there will be two or there will be one at the end. If there are two, then what do you mean by Kaivalya? They have no answer to anything, but they will simply say union of jivatma and paramatma is called bas, and that is the beginning and that is the end of their definition, meaning and everything. Now it is our sacred duty to remove the confusion. So let us do it. Now there is, I can't see here anything. There is no concept of jivatma and paramatma in yoga system. In the beginning, let me say that in yoga system, there is no concept of jivatma and paramatma in the first place. There is nothing called jivatma, or there is nothing called paramatma in yoga system. There are two realities in yoga system. One is Prakriti and the other one is Purusha. They are also known as Drushya. Prakriti is known as Drushya and Purusha is known as Drashta. Prakriti is insentient. Prakriti has no consciousness. It is unconscious, jada. And Purusha is consciousness. In me, the consciousness is Purusha. The Chaitanya is Purusha, and rest of my body, my mind, my buddhi, my indriyas, everything else belongs to the Prakriti. They are jada. They have no consciousness. Only the Purusha, the drashta, the self, we may call it self, it is the consciousness. So Purusha is consciousness, or drashta is consciousness, and everything else is Prakriti. And then what happens? Then union, they are united all the time. This Prakriti and Purusha, they are united all the time. So yoga is not going to, you are not going to unite anything. You are, Prakriti and Purusha are already united. Purusha and Prakriti are already united, and their union is the cause of all sorrows. In yoga system, there is another sutra. So their union is the cause of all sorrows. Then why they are united? Because of anadi avidya. Union is, their union is due to avidya. Because of Ajnana, they are united. The body, mind, and the self, the Purusha, they are united together. And this is because of the, it is because of avidya only. Now, actually, the disunion is yoga. Ultimately, to disunite the Prakriti from the Purusha, the non-self from the self, is yoga. Yoga is to disunite the self from the non-self. So yoga is the disunion of Purusha from Prakriti, or self from the non-self. Prakriti is non-self and Purusha is self. Tadabhavat sanjoga bhavahanam tadrushehe kaivalyam. Tadabhavat sanjoga bhavat. Here, sanjoga when? Tadabhavat sanjoga bhavat. Avidya abhavat sanjoga bhavahanam tadrushehe kaivalyam. Sanjoga se abhava. Yoga is sanjoga se abhava. So yoga is not sanjoga, but sanjoga se abhava. Tad drusehe kaivalyam, and that is the state of kaivalya of the drusi. Drusi mane tad drusehe kaivalyam means drashta. That is the kaivalya of the drashta. So in Rajamartanda Vrutti also we find the same thing. Pung prakruti or vyoga pi yoga iti dito jaya. The vyoga of Purusha and Prakriti, pung prakruti. From pung means puman, or Purusha. Prakriti, Purusha and Prakriti, vyoga of Purusha and Prakriti is called yoga. In fact, yoga is nothing but the disunion of the self from the non-self. Now, yoga is not union, stated in clear terms in our yogic text. Vachaspati Mishra says, Juj samadho iti asmat vyutpannaha samadhyarthaha natu jujir yoga iti asmat sanyogartha. In Tattva Vaisharadi Tika of Yoga Sutra, he clearly writes that the word yoga is derived from the root juj samadho and not from the root jujir yoga. Therefore, yoga means samadhi, not union. No union, because they are already united and they are suffering for that. And they again, Vijnana Bhikshu, he writes, Tatra Juj Samadhaviti, Yoga Lakhanasya Prasiddhatva Lakhanantara Kakheva Kankhyaeva Nasti. This is in Yoga Bhartika, he writes. The meaning of yoga is samadhi, since it is derived from the root Juj Samadho. It is so clear that there is no scope for any other definition. It is so clear that there can't be any other definition of yoga, Vijnana Bhikshu. Then Hariharananda Aranyaka in Bhaswati Tika, he writes, Nacha Sanyogartha Koyam Yoga. This yoga is not Sanyogartha. This yoga means the yoga in context, the yoga about which we are talking, that is not Sanyogartha Yoga. Sanyogartha Yoga is 1 plus 1 is 2. That is Sanyogartha Yoga. This yoga is not Sanyogartha. Now, the cause of the confusion. Yes, there are some causes of this confusion, because of which this confusion has come. That the word yoga is confused as union has some causes also. There are some mentions in some texts. For example, Yoga Jagyamalkya. Sanyoga yoga ityukta jivatma paramatmanaha. Here he writes, Jagyamalkya writes, the union of Jivatma and Paramatma is yoga. So this is, let us analyze this point. Point wise, you will analyze this, what he actually means. Now, Yoga Jagyamalkya is a smriti book, not a book of yoga. Strictly, it is not a book of yoga, it is a book of smriti. Dharma Shastram Tubai Smriti, it is a book of Dharma Shastra. So it is a code of conduct. It is not strictly a book of yoga. So it is not a testimony for yoga. It is not, it cannot authenticate anything. It is not a testimony, praman. Testimony means praman. It is not a praman of yoga. Number two, Jagyamalkya has only mentioned that union of Jivatma and Paramatma is yoga, but he has not written anything about the Jivatma or Paramatma. Who is Jivatma? Who is Paramatma? Why they are separated? Why should they be united? What are the process? What is the process of union? Nothing he has written. Simply this half sentence he has written. Then number three, after giving this statement that Jivatma Paramatma Sanyoga Yoga Ityahu Jivatma Paramatma Noha, he immediately starts discussing about the practices of Ashtanga Yoga, like Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, and all these things he starts discussing. If your union, if your Jivatma Paramatma, union of Jivatma Paramatma is yoga, then how Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, all these things? Because it will ultimately, it will lead to Samadhi, where there is Chitta Vritti Nirodha. So practice of Ashtanga Yoga would ultimately end with Samadhi, which is not any union. Tadevartha Matra Nirvasam Swarupa Sunyam Iva Samadhi. So Samadhi is already we have discussed. Samadhi Chitta Vritti Nirodha. So ultimately he is also going to the Chitta Vritti Nirodha state. Although he has written half a sentence that Sanjaga Yoga Ityahu Jivatma Paramatma, that's all. In the whole book, he has nowhere mentioned how you should go, how they will be united ultimately, and whether it is a physical union or a mental union, or how, if physical union, whether Jivatma has a body and Paramatma has a body, he doesn't have a body, he doesn't have a mind, and how this Jivatma will be united with that Paramatma, nothing he has written. So, therefore the mention of union of Jivatma and Paramatma is only metaphoric or unreal. It is metaphoric only. It is not real. Now, in fact, there is a total transformation of a human being when he reaches the final stage of yoga. He is established in his own original form, and that is the journey of yoga. He starts from the state where he is united with other non-selves, and he then gradually proceeds and reaches a state where there is nothing else but only himself. Tadadrashtu swarupe avasthana. He becomes single, there is nothing else with him. That is the state of samadhi, and that is yoga. Now, final state therefore is called kaivalya. It is called kaivalya. Kaivalya means kevalasya bhavaha. Kevala means only one. He is only one. The final stage is therefore called kaivalya. Then he is only one. One of the synonyms of yoga is advaita. In Hatha Yoga Pratipika, we have seen the synonyms of yoga. Raja Yoga Samadhischa Unmanicha Mananmani. Amaratvam Layastattvam Sunyam Param Padam. Amanaskam Tatha Advaitam. Advaita is another synonym of samadhi or yoga. Then when advaita, that means non-dual. At all. How can there be any union? Because there is no second entity. And then there is another synonym that is called Niralamba. Niralamba means supportless. He is no support. He is single, supportless. Therefore, how can yoga be any union? Union means more than one. So, yoga is not union. It is the state of samadhi. It is the chitta vritti nirodha, state of chitta vritti nirodha. So like this, we have to remove the confusion from the minds of people. Now, multiple meaning of the word yoga. Every word has multiple meanings, many meanings of a single word. Suppose sandhava, the word sandhava. Sandhava means sandhava ghotaka and also sandhava labana. So there are many meanings of a single word. So let us see some other meanings of the word yoga, which is not samadhi. The word is yoga, but other meanings. Let us see other meanings of yoga. Yoga is a word of multiple meanings. In Mediniposo, we find these meanings. Yoga, yoga purvartha samprapto, sangati dhyana juktisu, vapus karye prayogecha viskambhadisu bhesaje. These are the meanings of the word yoga. Yoga has these meanings. The number one meaning, achievement of new things. Number two, association. Number three, dhyana-related practices. Number four, stability of body. Number five, application. Number six, preparation of medicine by mixture. That is also yoga. Now let us analyze these things. Apurvartha samprapti. Apurvartha samprapti means to get what you have not already got. Tesang vitya abhijuktanang yoga khemang bahamyaham. Here yoga is apurva artha samprapti. Here Lord says, jatesang nitya abhijuktanam yoga khemam bahamyam. I take the responsibility of the yoga and khema of such devotees. So here yoga is apurva artha samprapti. So attainment of new things. Here yoga is new achievements. Khema means preservation of the achieved. Number two is sangati, association or union. Number three, dhyana juktisu, dhyana related matters, samadhi. Then vapustarja, stability of the body. Then prayoga, application. Gita is called a yoga shastra because it is a prayoga shastra. Actually, it is a practical book. We can practice the instructions given in Gita. So it is yoga shastra, Srimad Bhagavata Gitayam. The yoga shastra, that yoga is nothing but application, prayoga shastra. Number six, preparation of medicine by mixture. In Ayurveda, this word yoga is used. Nisha amaliki yoga, nisha and amalaki. Nisha means aritra and amalaki means aula. So they are yoga, their combination, how to prepare a medicine by combining these two. This yoga is a word of Ayurveda. Now, like many other meanings, union is also a meaning. Here we come to point. Again, we come back to the point. There are many meanings of the word yoga. So union is also a meaning. It has nothing to do with the yoga in context. The yoga that we are discussing, it has nothing to do with that. Yoga is also used to name the chapters of Gita, like Arjuna Vishada Yoga, etc. It has nothing to do with the original meaning of yoga. Simply, the names are yoga. Just like chapters are named as Nishwasa, Utshwasa, Valli, and like this, so also it is yoga. It should not be confused with the main meaning of yoga, that is samadhi. All these things, none of the meanings should be confused with the main meaning of yoga, that is samadhi, citta vritti nirodha. Now, there are also some affiliated meanings. Affiliated meaning means yoga is samadhi, but some other words related to samadhi, also they yoga also means these things. Yoga is used for these things. For example, yoga is used for yogangas. What are yogangas? Asana pranayama, ashtanga, asana pranayama, etc., pratyahara, dhyana, like this. These are yogangas. So dhyana yoga, we say dhyana yoga, asana yoga, pratyahara yoga. These are yogangas, but the word yoga is associated with them. Then number two, any means of liberation is also named as yoga. For example, bhakti yoga, karma yoga, etc. These are also called yoga. So yoga sara sangraha gives these two meanings. It says, yogangesu jnana bhakti karma desu cha yoga sabdo, yoga sadhana tvar mukhya payatva cha gona iti. In yoga sara sangraha, we find this reference. So yoga is to absolutely conquer the mind. It is the highest state of a human being. It leads to liberation. Finally, we come to the conclusion that yoga is absolutely to conquer the mind absolutely. It is the highest state of a human being. Then it leads to liberation. In Amruta Bindu Upanishad, we find a very good mantra. Manayava manushyanam karanam bandhu mukhyaya bandhaya vishaya sanghi. So the mind, everything is to deal with the mind. Mana, because mana is the cause of our bondage and liberation. When the mind is attached to the world, it creates bondage. But when it is buddhi-less, then it leads to liberation. So yoga is to conquer the mind. In one sentence, if we want to say, what is yoga? Yoga is nothing but to conquer the mind, and the state of samadhi is nothing but the conquered state of mind. When absolutely conquered, is in the state of samadhi. I thank you for listening to this lecture. If you have any question, I shall be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.
I have a question, madam.
Yes, please. Your name, please.
Namo Namaha Mahodaya. My name is Rathin Bishwas. I am from Purva Medinpur, West Bengal.
Yes.
My question is that jo karne se madam ji wo chitta vritti ke nirodh hota hai. To jo karne se
nirodh yoganga karne se.
हाँ तो ये हम तो ये जो करने से कि आत्मा से परमात्मा तक मिलन हो सकता है क्या, ये मेरा फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है. और जो करने से आत्मा शुद्ध हो जाता है और इस संसार बंधन से कि मुक्त हो सकते हैं क्या हम जोग करने से. और आपने बताया कि जोग नॉट अ यूनियन, दिस इज अ समाधि, जोगा मीन्स. तो जो करने से वो जो
व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय योगा, यू टेल मी. योग करने से का मतलब योगांग करने से, योग को वी आर गोइंग टू रीच द स्टेट ऑफ योगा.
तो जो करने से सेल्फ रियलाइज, जो करने से कि ये सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन होता है कि सिन्यन्तु विश्वे अमृतस्य पुत्राः वयं सर्वे अमृतस्य पुत्राः, ये कि वो सेल्फ हीलिंग होता है, और ये मुझे बताइए.
I discussed the same thing.
I am the super soul in the world.
Whether ये... self-realization, what do you mean by self? Tadadvastu swarupe vasthanam, I told you. What is Swarupa Avasthanam? That is self realization. What is Kaivalya? That is self realization. I don't think you have listened the lecture mindfully because everything was discussed in detail. Everything and yog karne se matlab nahi, yoganga ka practice kiya jata hai and we reach the state of yoga. And ultimately, finally, I said that yoganga, the word yoga is also used for yogangas. We practice yogangas and we reach the state of yoga. Yoga is the final state. Yoga samadhi, that final state is called yoga. What we practice are yogangas. Asana.
Hello.
Doing
yes,
some
madam.
Asana.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Okay.
Hello, madam.
Yes. Yes, please.
हाँ, मैं जय ठाकर बोल रहा हूँ सूरत से.
Yes, yes.
ये आपने जो बताया वो जो अपने आठ अंग जो है उसके ऊपर हम काम करेंगे तो जो सर अभी पूछ रहे थे वहां पे पहुंच सकते हैं, ऐसा उसका निचोड़ आ रहा है ना?
ना मैं समझी नहीं. I could not understand you.
जैसे जो आठ अंग है अपने योग के,
हाँ,
उनको फॉलो करेंगे तो समाधि पे जा सकते हैं.
हाँ, तो
वही है ना इसका पूरा जो. बस वही, और कुछ नहीं.
नहीं नहीं, खाली अष्टांग मार्ग एकमात्र रास्ता नहीं.
ओके.
उसका योग सूत्र का पहला सूत्र शुरू से बोलिए, कहिए शुरू से. योग सूत्र आपने पढ़ा होगा, पहले पहला सूत्र बताइए, दूसरा बताइए, तीसरा बताइए, चौथा बताइए. अथ योगानुशासनम योगश्चित्त वृत्ति निरोध तदा दृष्टु स्वरूप अवस्थानम वृत्ति सारूप्यम इतरत्र ऋतयः पञ्चतयः क्लिष्टाक्लिष्टाः देन प्रमाण विपर्य विकल्प निद्रा स्मृतयः देन व्हाट इज प्रमाण विकल्प ऑल दीस थिंग्स आर डिस्कस्ड देन ही सेज वैराग्य अभ्यास वैराग्य भयंकर निरोध अभ्यास एंड वैराग्य इज द फर्स्ट मेथड अभ्यास एंड वैराग्य अष्टांग योग साधना इज वन ऑफ द मेथड्स दैट इज नॉट द ओनली मेथड अभ्यास वैराग्य अभ्यास अभ्यास वैराग्य भयंकर निरोध से जो वहां लिखा है कि अभ्यास वैराग्य से ही उसका निरोध होता है. अभ्यास करना पड़ेगा एंड वैराग्य करना पड़ेगा.
ओके ओके. हां
ठीक है.
Is there any questions?
I think Niranjan has some questions.
Yes. No. Just I am waiting
to conclude.
Question from the audience and the scholars.
Actually, let me just 1 minute again. Actually, when one thing is spread like anything, when you go on speaking, the repeating the same thing, yoga is union, jivatma and parmatma, yoga is union, jivatma, and tell me who is jivatma and who is parmatma, how they are united, why they are separated. You must have a theory. There is no theory, just union of, because yoga is union. Yoga is not union, there are other meanings also. Yoga is samadhi. Union is one of the meanings, which has nothing to do with this. So because it is spread like anything, now some people have come out, they are saying that yoga means union of the body and mind and self. Now they have, I don't have words for them. So immature. And so they do not know ABC of yoga. Because the union of the body, mind and the self, we are suffering so much. Adeko Vasishta Siva Kevaloham. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the indriyas. I am only the self, that is yoga. And if you say that yoga means to unite the body and the mind and the self, that is yoga, that means you do not know the ABC of yoga. You don't have the right to speak on yoga at all. Some people have now come out. I don't know from where they are coming out and how they are finding these theories. They are preparing their own theories. They have nothing, they have no acquaintance with Shastra. यस
एनी क्वेश्चन
It seems there is no questions, sir.
No, there is no question. I don't think there should be any question because to the best of my capability, I have tried to clarify every point.
Very nice.
Every single point I have tried to clarify. And by giving sufficient proofs, without proof, I never say a single word. And proofs from the original text, from the authentic text, I take a lot of pain to prepare one lecture because yes. I have to read many books and then I collect materials and then I prepare a lecture. It takes a lot of time
yes.
and I try my best to clarify every single point.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
मैम आई हैव वन क्वेश्चन
आप
बता सकते हो कि कौन सी बुक के अंदर ये नॉलेज है हमें भी पढ़नी है इसलिए
आप क्या करते हैं पहले बताइए
जी मैं वैसे तो कुछ नहीं करती हूँ भागवत कथा को पढ़ने की कोशिश कर रही हूँ और मुझे वैसे और भी बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन हैं पर मैं अभी वेट कर रही हूँ क्योंकि मैं अभी अभी जुड़ी हूँ कुछ सेशन ही मैंने अटेंड किए हैं तो मैं कोशिश कर रही हूँ कि ये जो हो रहा है वो सब क्या हो रहा है आप सब लोग कौन हैं आप सब लोगों का जो प्रोफेशन है वो क्या है वो सब समझ रही हूँ लेकिन उसके बाद
संस्कृत फोरम में विल आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन
क्या
ये तो फोरम आई एम ए गेस्ट हियर सो ऑर्गेनाइजर्स कैन आंसर योर क्वेश्चन मैडम ओके निरंजन लेट अस प्रोसीड
आचार्य वैशाली जी ये जो आपका क्वेश्चन है ये हमारे जो ग्लोबल संस्कृत फोरम है इंटरनेशनल फोरम है इंटरनेशनल तो इसमें जो ऑल टाइप ऑफ एकेडमिक एक्टिविटीज होता है जो सेमिनार स्पेशल लेक्चर्स है सारी दुनिया में क्या क्या संस्कृत के बारे में हमारे जो परंपरा में जो इंडोलॉजी के बारे में क्या चल रहा है तो इसमें चर्चा होता है ये ऑल इंडिया बेसिस में लिमिटेड नहीं है आज मेरे वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश दीपिका बणिक फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश राजशाही यूनिवर्सिटी संस्कृत में प्रोफेसर है लैंग्वेज डिपार्टमेंट में है वो भी थे ऐसे कभी कभी साउथ इंडियन से होते हैं मतलब साउथ कोरिया से होते हैं ऑल ओवर वर्ल्ड से होते हैं
अंतरराष्ट्रीय लेवल से भी सब लोग होते हैं
तो ये बहुत कि हमने जैसे हम स्टेट वाइज भी उसको तैयार किए हैं ये संस्कृत फोरम है इंटरनेशनल बॉडी है और इसको हम स्टेट वाइज बनाए हैं तो ये जो हमारे आज जो स्पेशल लेक्चर सीरीज होता है प्रोफेसर इंदुलता दास डायरेक्टर ऑफ एकेडमी ऑफ युगो एंड ओरिएंटल स्टडीज फ्रॉम भुवनेश्वर सब एक एक स्कॉलर सुनते हैं वो स्कॉलर हमको मतलब ऐसे ज्ञान वितरण करते हैं तो उसमें ज्ञान का चर्चा होता है ये
मुझे मेरे कुछ प्रश्न और भी रखने हैं यदि हमारे सेशन को पूरा करने में आप सब लोगों का समय व्यय ना हो रहा हो तो
बोलिए बोलिए संक्षिप्त में बोलिए
नहीं ऐसे अगर ऐसा है तो हम लोग क्या एक बार जो लोग संस्कृत के विशेषज्ञ है उनको सबको जोड़ के क्या हम एक सेशन कर सकते हैं
हाँ बिल्कुल हमारा ये उद्देश्य है महीना में एक माह दो महीना में हम एक इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार करते हैं तो सारी वर्ल्ड से स्कॉलर जुड़ते हैं जैसे आप जो आपका जो प्रपोजल है ये हम ऑलरेडी ये कर रहे हैं
ओके आज जो मैम ने जो भी पूरा सेशन किया वो अगर हम भागवत के अकॉर्डिंग देखे जाए तो उसमें जो सांख्य शास्त्र है कपिल नारायण का, जो माता देवहूति को ज्ञान दिया गया है, उसमें ये सारी की सारी बात है। लेकिन जब मैम ने कहा कि ऐसे बहुत सारी बुक्स मैंने पढ़ी है और उनमें से मैंने ये ज्ञान प्राप्त किया है, तो मैंने सोचा कि क्यों ना पूछा जाए कि आपने कौन कौन सी बुक्स है, इसलिए मैंने ये प्रश्न पूछा था।
ये सारी भारतीय संस्कृति का जितना भी किताब है, वेद से लेकर जो पुराण से लेकर महाभारत लेकर होता है, भागवत का चर्चा कर रहे हैं उसमें संस्कृत में है, तो ये आज तक हमारे भारतीय परंपरा में जितना प्रेस्क्राइब्ड टेक्स्ट है ये उसी टेक्स्ट के हिसाब से, जैसे आज मैडम का जो लेक्चर था, ये लेक्चर ये जो युग शास्त्र में से, युग सूत्र से, युग वाशिष्ठ से, चक्र निरूपण, ये सब हट युग के एक एक लेकर शास्त्र के आधार से ये ज्ञान का जो विकास होता है।
जी जी
ठीक है। आप हमारे ये जो ग्लोबल संस्कृत फोरम है, आपका आईडी नंबर और कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर दीजिए, आप जुड़िए उसमें, आपका ईमेल एड्रेस और कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर दीजिए, आपको जुड़ाएंगे और इसमें क्या चल रहा है आपको पता चलेगा। यहाँ
हेलो।
हाँ जी,
हाँ जी सर, निरंजन सर।
हाँ जी बोलिए।
हाँ जी, जय ठाकर बोल रहा हूँ। इसमें सर मैडम ये पीपीटी मिल सकती है क्या, डिटेल थोड़ी इसके बारे में हमने जो डिस्कस किया मैडम ने।
जी जी, हमारे ये है तैयार, यूट्यूब में है जो लेक्चर हुआ।
अच्छा,
है
यूट्यूब, ओके।
लेक्चर तो आप हमारे एक ग्रुप में जुड़िए तो सारी जानकारी आपको पता चल जाएगी इंडिविजुअली।
तो मैं आपको मेरा नंबर और मेल आईडी इस ग्रुप में डाल देता हूँ, ठीक है।
जी जी, आप मेल आईडी और व्हाट्सएप नंबर
चैट बॉक्स में डाल देता हूँ। यस सर, थैंक यू।
ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है,
ओके, थैंक यू।
बहुत बढ़िया है आज का जो सेशन है, मैंने देखता हूँ जो सारी इंडिया से और जो बांग्लादेश से जुड़े हैं, तो इसलिए आज का सेशन बहुत बढ़िया हुआ है। और मैडम का ये जो व्यापक दृष्टि से, जब ब्रॉडली जैसे हम सिर्फ जानते हैं जे सबको पता है जो संस्कृत है और नॉन संस्कृत पर्सन है उनको पता है जे युग चित्तवृत्ति निरुद्ध, युग चित्तवृत्ति निरुद्ध इतना है। युग का मतलब जो चित्त का संयम करना है, लेकिन ये मैडम का लेक्चर से हमको एक ब्रॉड आईसाइड ये जो ये मिला है, जो मार्गदर्शन मिला है, जो जैसे देर आर मैंने मल्टीपल मीनिंग्स ऑफ द वर्ड युग जैसे बताया है। और ये जो गीता में इन्हें ऐसे बताते हैं अष्टादश युग है, तो गीता को जो युग शास्त्र बोलते हैं, ये सारी चीज हम ये शास्त्र से मिलता है, लेकिन ये शास्त्र को पढ़ने का जो हम अगर प्रयास करेंगे तो बहुत समय लगता है। लेकिन ये ग्लोबल संस्कृत फोरम का ये उद्देश्य है, जो ज्ञानी है, गुणी है, जिनका अनुभव है, जो शास्त्र निपुण है, शास्त्र विशारद है, जैसे मैडम देखिए कितना टेक्स्ट का उदाहरण उन्होंने दिए है और उनको डेफिनेशन के लिए कितना मेहनत करना पड़ता है, तो ये एक वास्तव दृष्टांत है, उदाहरण है। इसलिए हम सबको ये ग्लोबल संस्कृत फोरम में आह्वान करते हैं। और औपचारिक में मैं निवेदन करता हूँ अपना इस जो ऑनलाइन जो व्याख्यान में कोऑर्डिनेटर है डॉक्टर चिन्मय मंडल, वो औपचारिक धन्यवाद अर्पण करेंगे डॉक्टर।
यस सर, am I audible? Am I audible sir?
हाँ जी,
इनका ऑडिबल।
हाँ, ये जो ग्लोबल संस्कृत फोरम का जो फाउंडर है, जो सचिव रूप में, वो डॉक्टर राजेश कुमार मिश्र जी है, वो नालंदा विश्वविद्यालय का जो डिपार्टमेंट का अध्यापक है, तो उनका ये योजना है ये सारी दुनिया को, वर्ल्ड को कैसे जुड़े, अपना जो संस्कृति का भावना है, जो संस्कृत परंपरा है सबके पास ये जो मैसेज पहुंचे ये उनका कृतित्व है, तो इसलिए हम उनका आभार उनको आभार व्यक्त करते हैं। औपचारिक दृष्टि से डॉक्टर चिन्मय मंडल जी हम धन्यवाद अर्पण करेंगे।
यस सर, एम आई ऑडिबल सर? हेलो,
प्लीज।
यस यस, दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एन आइडियल टीचर हु वांट्स टू शेयर हर vast knowledge to the students or audience. She has the deep knowledge in yoga theory, not only the yoga theory but also the sankhya theory of knowledge. I am sure that the lecture will help the teachers, students, scholars to their and students to their studies. I convey my sincere thanks and gratitude and pranam to Professor Das for her interesting lecture. Many university college teachers, research scholars, students are associated with this lecture. We are very much thankful and we are very much kind enough to their for their attendance. The founder member of the Global Sanskrit Forum, Dr. Rajesh Kumar Mishra, professor of Nabunalanda Mahabihar University. She is now with us. Always she inspire us to organize such a lecture. I convey special thanks to him. I am thankful to our honorable president, Professor Niranjan Jena, Department of Sanskrit and Pali Prakrit, Vishwabharati University. She has the great effort to organize this special lecture. I am thankful to our honorable members and dignitaries. Thank you, madam. Thank you all. Now the Shanti Mantras. Om Sahana Bhavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Saha Viryam Karovavahai Tejasvi Navadhitamastu Ma Vidvishavahai Om Swantihi Swantihi Swantihi.